my latest book that is called in Spanish No Siento Nada. It's an investigation of the love life of Leonardo DiCaprio, because he's famous for changing his girlfriend very often, like once a year or every 6 months. I use him as an example because I think that we are all becoming more and more like Leonardo. When I choose a topic to write a book about, it has to be a topic that I feel really connected to. That's something that is really about me in some way. Like in the case of this book, for example, I felt like I want to understand, like, why does love end? Like, why do you stop being in love? I think that one reason that it is difficult to feel attached in our time is that we live in a very, very, very developed consumer culture, where more and more things in our lives become more and more like commodities or consumer objects. One very common thing on dating sites is, for example, to write a list about what qualities you look for in a partner. So it kind of that you go into the situation as a consumer who is looking for a certain kind of object. If this person suddenly has some kind of fault, you feel disappointed and you want another object, another item. And I think this attitude towards finding someone is kind of working against the feeling of falling in love. When it comes to love, it has like a very uncontrollable element. You just have to kind of accept that things happen to you that you are not in control of yourself. And that is an experience that I think that we are getting less and less able to handle. I have always felt very, dictated by love, and it really bothered me because I really wanted to be independent. And also, being a feminist, I felt like, how is it possible that I'm so dominated by these weird forces? Like, for example, being very, very unhappily in love with someone that is not in love with you back, and so on. So I made a book 10 years ago, Los Sentimientos de Príncipe Carlos. It's a lot more about how women get oppressed by ideas about romantic love. It's about like the dangers maybe of engaging too much in romantic love, because like it can make you stuck in destructive relationships and so on. But then 10 years later, I really felt the need to make a book from another angle about this subject, partly because I have changed myself in these 10 years. And part of it is that I think society has changed. I got a letter from a French girl. She read first Los Sentimientos de Príncipe Carlos, and she was like, okay, I feel so happy, I feel so empowered, I will never have a boyfriend again, I'm so liberated. Then she read this one. This one is all about like accepting the power of love and so on. So she felt very confused and she was like, what's the right answer? I'm really happy when people tell me that the comics have affected them in positive ways or made them think in different ways or helped them. And quite often this happens, that people tell me that, especially with the feelings of Prince Charles. I remember also one time being in France and there was this one young girl who said, told me that she read the comic and she immediately broke up with her boyfriend, and then she gave the comic to her friend and that friend immediately broke up with her boyfriend, and then that person gave it to another friend and that friend immediately broke up with her boyfriend. And also that couples who started dating, that they have been reading this book together and like reading one chapter and then having a discussion about the chapter to decide how they should structure the relationships, like what should be the rules in the relationship.